What's next? We are going to stare at my pencil. Ooh, holding a pencil. What we're going to do next is we're going to add a row of icons down here. Well, not down here. I mean, technically inside this little box, but we're going to add a couple of icons over here, right? One icon is going to go to our website and one icon is going to go let people email us, right? Remember, this is a name card app, right? You got to let people contact you somehow. You can put a phone number and stuff if you want, but you know, whatever, up to you. So let's get ready to do this next part. To do that, I drew a little horizontal box, and in the horizontal box are going to be a couple of icons. Let's get the horizontal box first. Horizontal box belongs inside the VStack below the two pieces of text. I'm going to go over here, type HStack, open curly brace, and I'm going to leave the cursor inside the HStack. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put in my icons, and the way we do that is by using this plus button over here, and choose this little star icon. And you can see over here, here are thousands and thousands of free icons that you can use in your iOS app. And just to be aware of this, you can only use these in your iOS and other Apple device apps. These are all free, created by Apple. They look pretty good and they fit very well in any iOS app. It saves you from having to go online, you know, find a free icon, download it to your photo library and install it into your app. And you can just instead of use these. However, you need to know what you're looking for. So I need to look for something that represents a website or a link. If I search for web, nothing happens. If I go back, all right, I'm going to go search for, let's say, globe, right? A globe is kind of representative of a website, right? So I'm going to tap on the word globe over here. And here you go. It's got image system name globe. In fact, this was what we deleted in the first place. YJ, what are you doing? Why did you go do that? But, you know, I didn't quite remember that we needed this icon at the beginning. So, yeah, sorry about that. Okay, so here's an image, system name, colon, globe. Pretty nice. Let's get another one for email. So I'm going to do the process one more time. Plus, SF symbols. I could scroll down and browse, but I could probably just search for mail. I'm pretty sure there's an icon for mail. There you go. Let's choose mail. Okay, the globe and mail. Sounds good. Pretty sure that's something that's out there. What we want to do now is we want to make these icons tappable, right? We want to make these icons tappable so that when you tap on them, they will actually do something. And the way we do that is by using something called a link. It's a different view. It's called a link. And the way it's set up is fairly complex. So just bear with us and I will demonstrate what to do. So first things first, I'm going to give my two images some space. It's going to press enter. And that's something you might have noticed about SwiftUI. It doesn't matter how much space you leave in between lines. I think somewhere in an earlier section, I had a random blank line and I made no notice of it. And that's because it's perfectly fine to leave blank lines in between most of your code. So I'm going to go up here. I'm going to type in a link. A link requires a destination URL. So in this case, I'm going to link to a place called tk.sg/importantlink, right? tk.sg is my company's URL shortener. It's a thoroughly important link, right? So I'm going to type link, open bracket. And as I type link, it's going to give me some chances to autocomplete, right? What actually goes inside the link. There are various things that can go inside the link. I'm just going to type out this thing over here by typing destination, colon. And the destination over here, I unfortunately can't just type my URL directly inside here. I have to make something called a URL object. So just bear with me on this. URL, bracket, string, colon, https://tk.sg/importantlink. Don't forget the https, right, and the :// That's because you actually need to define the type of URL it is. I'll show you more about this when we do the email. You also need to put an exclamation mark after the first bracket, between the first two brackets. And that's because it's extra emphasis. Important link. No, I mean, it's something called optionals and we'll probably get into it at some point or we can read up more about it. After this, we're going to have an open curly brace. Press enter. And what this is here's a link and this is where it goes. What represents this link? Well, in this case, what represents the link is this image right here. So I'm just going to drag this down, right? This is easy enough because it's just one line. I just drag the curly brace, and now what's inside the link is this globe over here. You'll notice that the color has changed. The color has changed to this little teal color. We'll fix that in a moment. It's a bit hard to see, but let's look carefully at this again. Here is a link, and there's the destination inside the parameters, and what is represented by is an image of a globe. Okay, I'm going to do it next for my email address. So I'm going to just do this one more time. Link, destination, URL, URL string, colon, mail to, right? Mail to is a certain type of protocol. Mail to hello at tk.sg. Remember, put an exclamation mark for emphasis and curly braces. And finally, I'm going to ensconce this image inside here. I just love saying ensconce. Okay, so there you go. We can see, well, if you strain your eyes, you can kind of see these two links over here. All right, let's fix up the look of these links because they're kind of hard to see. One way you can do it is by changing your accent color, but I really kind of like that accent color for the app icon. Wait, no, the app icon is my face. That's okay. Let's just say I want to change it to a manual color. I want it to be nice and red. So I'm going to go over to the first link. I'm going to change the foreground color. Remember how you change the color or something? You just do foreground color. And once again, I'm going to choose autocomplete. And I'm going to say dot red. That's all right, I guess. And maybe I want it to be bigger, right? I can actually make this thing bigger. I can scale it up. And the nice thing about SF symbols is that you can actually go change the size of it by treating it as a font. So dot font, dot system, size, let's say 20. All right, as you can see, it became slightly larger. And maybe I want to give it some space from the text above. So I'm going to say dot padding, dot top. There you go. Unfortunately, that means that I need to take these modifiers and add them to the mail icon as well, which is not the worst thing in the world, but it's kind of repetitive and we don't really want to repeat our code. So here's one thing you can do. You can actually select these three lines. I'm going to use my keyboard to do it. I'm going to press Command X, which is the keyboard shortcut for cut. And I'm going to go to the end of the H tag, which is conveniently highlighted for me over here. And I'm going to paste them over here. And what that does is it actually applies these modifiers to the contents of the H tag, which is super convenient. So that means everything inside the H tag actually inherits these three modifiers. All right, I think we're done. This is pretty cool. We have a name card. We have a picture over here. We have some text. We've learned about modifiers, we've learned about stacks, we've learned about colors and enums and all kinds of cool stuff. If you want a working copy of the code, you can head over to this link on the screen and it's also in the video description below. So that's pretty much it. We can test out the links. I realize we haven't done that. And the great thing about the preview on the right-hand side is that it's completely interactive. You can actually tap on the links and they will actually bring you to the respective destinations. So if I tapped on the email link, it would actually open up my email app, which I don't really want to do on camera. But if I tap on this over here, it'll bring me to the important link. And, you know, it's a very important link. So let's go tap on it and see where it goes. Very important. Very, very important. Oh, no! All right. And that's it for now. To find out more, please tune in to our next installment at the same time, same channel, somewhere in the box that's going to show up on the screen at some point. If you like what we do, please like and subscribe. I cannot emphasize this enough. It's going to be really helpful for us to produce new content for you. And yeah, we'll see you soon. Merry Christmas. If it's not Christmas, Merry Christmas next year. Bye.